Let us have a discussion on gas in liquid solutions. That is, gas is present as the minor component, whereas liquid is present as the major component. When gas is present as a solute in the major component like liquid, which is present as solvent, then what will happen and what are the things associated with the gas in liquid solutions? Let us have a look. See, we might have examples for the gas and liquid. Suppose soda water is there. What is soda water? Soda water is carbon dioxide dissolved in water. Hence, what we can believe, soda water is nothing but what? This is water. In this water, carbon dioxide gas molecules are present here or there. These are carbon dioxide molecules. Similarly, aquatic life is getting surviving. That is due to what? Dissolved oxygen. Implies what? Whatever the lakes are there or whatever the reservoirs are there, in this water, normal water, oxygen molecules of atmosphere are present. That is said to be dissolved oxygen. Due to this dissolved oxygen, aquatic life is safe. Thus, here gas is present inside the liquid, gas is present inside the liquid. These of all are forming homogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures are nothing but what? Solutions. And this solution is a liquid solution, hence these are all our examples for gas in liquid solutions. Now let us define what is meant by solubility and what is the standardness of solubility of gas in liquid and what are the factors affecting on the solubility of a gas inside the liquid. Now solubility of a gas inside the liquid is defined like this. Here what we can define is, here I am taking 1 ml of solution. How much ml of liquid solution I am taking? 1 ml. This is 1 ml, or technically we can say it as 1 centimeter cube of solution is taken. This is 1 centimeter cube of dissolved gas containing solution, and if it is heated to evaporate or to make it free, whichever gas is present in the dissolved situation, to make it free, I am making this one to undergo a heating process. As a result, the gas will come out. On heating, what happens? The total gas present over here will come out. And if I measure the volume, and that volume is taken as reference for the solubility. That is, the amount of gas that is coming out of 1 centimeter cube of a liquid solution measured under standard conditions. Generally, under standard condition, the coming out gas volume is measured. Else, under the conditions of given temperature and pressure is also measured, these things are taken as reference for the solubility. If more gas comes under standard conditions, more will be the solubility. If less gas comes under standard conditions, lesser will be the solubility. Thus, solubility can be defined as the amount of gas that is coming out of 1 centimeter cube of liquid solution on heating under standard conditions is known as its solubility, or under given set of temperature and the pressure conditions is known as its solubility. Solubility is more, automatically what is the meaning? More amount of gas is dissolved. Solubility is less, what is the meaning? Less amount of gas is getting dissolved. Thus, solubility will gives the clear idea that whether the gas is present with excess amount or the gas is present with the lesser amount in the given solution. Thus, let us go for factors. What are the factors that can affect the solubility of higher solubility or lower solubility, or overall solubility of a gas, how it is getting influenced by the factors? Yes, there are majorly three varieties of factors that can influence the solubility. One is nature of interactions between solvent and the solute. Whichever gas we are taking, that gas associated with the solvent, whatever we are taking, nature of interactions between them is one of the deciding factor. And second one is temperature. Temperature, under which conditions of temperature the solubility action is going to be taking place, whether it is lower temperature or it is high temperature. Then what will happen if it is lower temperature? What will happen if it is higher temperature? That is also one of the deciding factor. And a special important and discussion eligibility related another one factor that decides the solubility is pressure. So pressure is exclusive discussion that we will make. Now we will go one by one factors that are influencing over the solubility of a gas inside the solvent to make a saturated solution.
Here also in solubility you have to take care that the saturated solution of 1 cm cube has to be taken, and if it is heated to collect the gas present in it, and the collected amount of gas is measured under standard conditions or under given set of conditions, the volume of the gas that is coming out is taken as reference for the solubility. The more gas comes out, we can consider more will be the solubility. The less gas comes out, we consider that it is having lesser will be the solubility. Let us go for case 1, nature of the gas, nature of interactions between solvent as well as the solute. See, there are many varieties of gases and many varieties of solvents. Some of the gases are soluble to maximum extent in the solvent, and some of the gases are soluble to the lesser extent in the solvent. Suppose if I take aqueous solutions like water I am taking, in that water HCl is a gas, sulfur dioxide is a gas, ammonia is a gas. These gases are getting soluble to the maximum extent, whereas gases like helium is there, gases like nitrogen is there, gases like oxygen are there. These are some set of gases. Solubility, with reference of solubility, if we consider, these gases are highly soluble inside the water, whereas these gases are soluble to a lesser extent in relative to the other gases which are listed on the board. These are highly soluble gases, these are lesser soluble gases. Why? Because here what happens is water molecule chemically reacts with these gases and forms new compounds. Due to this reason, what happens is more amount of solubility is present. Suppose water is there, water on reaction with HCl it forms aqueous HCl solution. Similarly, sulfur dioxide forms sulfurous acid H2SO3, ammonia forms ammonium hydroxide solution. These are chemically reacting with the water. As a result of this chemical reaction, they are forming new chemical compounds. Due to this reason, more amount of compound is going to be dissolved. Why it is so? Because whatever the dissolved is there, dissolved is converted to some other new species. Now there is a chance for dissolution of extra amount of the gases. In that way, more amount of gas can be getting dissolved in this. So therefore, solubility of these gases is very high. Whereas if I go for solubility of inert gases, solubility like helium, solubility of triple bond containing nitrogen, symmetric gases, similarly oxygen gas, these gases are less soluble because they are present as it is. They never undergo any kind of chemical reaction with the solvent. They present ideally, so therefore these gases solubility will be less. Thus, nature of interactions between solvent and solute is one of the deciding factor. The solute molecules which chemically interact with the solvent and forms new compounds, such kind of compounds are soluble to the maximum extent compared to the other substances. So therefore these gases are highly soluble because they chemically react. Whereas in relation with this, in relation to this, these gases are less soluble because they never undergo any kind of chemical reaction, neither never undergo any kind of association, dissociation or chemical reaction with the solvent molecules. Such kind of gases are having less solubility in relation to the other. There is a special case, some particular gases. So here also we can see, here helium is there, nitrogen is there, oxygen is there. Out of these gases also, the solubility of oxygen is greater compared to the nitrogen, compared to the helium, because it is a single atom based molecule. It is more systematic, more symmetrical molecule. There is no dipole moment, and the chance of induction related to the dipole moment is also very less. Whereas in case of nitrogen, in case of oxygen, somewhat induced dipole moment quantity is considerable. And moreover, in between oxygen and nitrogen also, if you look at, it is having triple bond, more close interactions. Dispersion chances are very less. But whereas oxygen slightly undergoes dispersion in relation to this, so therefore out of these non-reacting gases also, on behalf of structure, on behalf of dipole moment nature, on behalf of induction associated with the dipole moment, if we consider, solubility of oxygen is greater compared to the nitrogen, compared to the helium. This is nothing but what? Nature of interactions between solvent as well as solute that decides the solubility of the gas. That is, to form a saturated solution, amount of this gas required will be very very higher, whereas amount of these gases are relatively less. In this also oxygen quantity in ml if we consider it will be higher, whereas nitrogen is second higher. Helium required to form a saturated solution of gas is little. This is related to the nature. And second one is temperature. Temperature is easily understood. Suppose if I take solvent molecule, whereas solvent molecule plus gas both are interacting, as a result it is forming what? Homogeneous mixture, that is nothing but what? Solution. In this process, suppose some amount of heat energy is always released, that is this process is considered as exothermic reaction. What is this reaction? Exothermic reaction. The meaning of exothermic is here interaction exists between the gaseous molecules as well as solvent molecules. This gaseous molecules interaction leads to the formation of solution. That interaction relevant amount of energy will be coming out, and that energy is appearing in the form of heat energy. Hence this reaction is generally considered as an exothermic reaction. Thus in general all varieties of gases, when they dissolve inside the solvent, they liberate some amount of heat. Hence mathematically, chemically, we can write that it comes under the category of exothermic reaction. So therefore, by applying chemical thermodynamics, by applying De Chatelier principle, it is exothermic reaction. The spontaneousness of the reaction, otherwise progress of reaction in terms of forward direction, if we look, then that is possible at low temperature. Whereas at high temperature, the kinetic energy of molecules increases, kinetic energy of the gas molecules also increases, kinetic energy of the dissolved gas molecules also increases. They want to attain perfect gas molecule features, so therefore they want to come out of the solution. So therefore what happens is, at high temperature, the dissolved content of gas decreases, that is nothing but what? Solubility decreases. Generally what we can say, suppose T1 is lower temperature, T2 is high temperature. Low temperature implies what? Less kinetic energy they are associated, and here they are having more kinetic energy. If they are having more kinetic energy, then they want to acquire perfect gas nature. Perfect gas nature they want to acquire. Thus, here in this case, what will happen to the solubility? Solubility decreases. But whereas at low temperature, what happens is, they don't want the perfect gas nature. They will be continued in the dissolved situation also. That is, seized situation also they are ready to maintain. With less disorder also they want to continue. So therefore, relatively, if temperature is less, then what will happen? Solubility is more. If temperature is more, then what happens is, solubility is less. In that way, effect of temperature is present. Now, there is a special case. Certain gases like helium is a gas, and inert gases like helium and some other gases. Here what happens is, under non-aqueous solutions, if it is not the water, non-aqueous solutions like alcohol is there, ether is there, benzene is there, DCM is there, chloroform is there. Under those particular non-aqueous solvents, inert gases like helium and all other gases, what they will do is, in a certain range of temperature, with increasing of temperature, their solubility increases, because attraction strength with increasing of kinetic energy, with increasing of rotation of the molecules, the attraction strength increases. As a result, within certain temperature range, in non-aqueous solvents, inert gases like helium and other gases, solubility increases. But in general, what we can coin is, for all varieties of solvents, for all varieties of gases, with increasing of temperature, solubility decreases. At lower temperature, relative amount of solubility is more. Effect of pressure on solubility of gas. See, there is a gas cylinder. There is a cylinder which is filled with liquid, and it is a sealed cylinder connected with another one gas. This is the gas. Now here these gas molecules came over the surface of the liquid. It is a sealed system. Suppose if I apply
high pressure, more will be the gas coming out here. Higher will be the pressure of the gas. If I apply less pressure, lesser number of gas molecules will be present over the liquid surface and lesser will be the pressure. Then what will happen to the amount of dissolved gas? If more gas is present or less gas is present in proportionation, some gas molecules will be getting dissolved inside the liquid. Now, effect of pressure, there are two routes related to the study. Henry made the discussion, that is Henry's first law for the discussion, and here also we are having another one law, that is said to be Henry's second law. Let us go for Henry's first law. What he will say is related to the pressure over the solubility of a gas inside the solvent to form a homogeneous mixture. So case 1 we are discussing, later we will go for the case 2. Henry's first law, what he will say is every gas molecule is having some weight, some mass. The mass of the gas dissolved inside the solution is proportional to the partial pressure of the gas present over the solution on its surface. See, here pressure is there. This is the pressure inside the solution chamber. Whichever pressure is offered by the gaseous molecules, that pressure is this one. If this pressure increases, suppose pressure is 1 atmosphere, what happens? Some 100 molecules are there over the surface. Whereas pressure is 200 atmosphere, 2 atmospheres, then 200 molecules are there over the surface. As a result, what happens is, compared to the first case to the second case, the more the pressure applied, more amount of gas will be dissolved in place. What? The dissolved mass, this is M, M is indicated by the mass of the dissolved gases. So therefore, the dissolved mass of the gas increases with increasing of the pressure. At lower pressure, lower number of gas molecules are there. Hence, minimum number of gas molecules are getting dissolved. With increasing of pressure in proportionation, more number of gas molecules are present on the surface. More gas is getting dissolved in place. What? Higher mass, higher amount of mass is getting dissolved over the dissolved in the solvent. Thus, mass of the gas dissolved in the liquid is proportional to the partial pressure of the gas. This is given by Henry, and this law is said to be the first law of Henry. Hence, it is known as Henry's first law. Suppose, if I take the graph, you take any variety of the gas. For the gas, generally what happens is, if I am taking mass on the y-axis, pressure on the x-axis, this is partial pressure of the gas and this is mass of the gas. In the beginning, there is no partial pressure. No amount of gas is getting dissolved. Suppose if partial pressure increases, then with increasing of partial pressure, some extra amount of gas is getting dissolved. Still on increasing of partial pressure, what happens here? Still more gas is getting dissolved. That is, here low pressure implies what? Lower mass is getting dissolved. High pressure implies what? Higher mass is getting dissolved. This is said to be Henry's first law. Whereas, if I go for this particular one in a mathematical format, this can be given by mass is equal to Henry's constant into partial pressure of the gas. This is Henry's first constant. Here the units of Henry's constant KH will be given by what? Mass by pressure. That implies what? Grams per atmosphere. Otherwise any other unit that we can take, grams per atmosphere, any other unit that we can take as per the pressure unit, it is having its units. See here, this KH depends on many varieties of things. Suppose if I take different varieties of gases, some gases are having higher solubility, some gases are having lower solubility on behalf of interaction strength. So therefore, gases which are having different solubilities in place, what different amount of mass is going to be dissolved. I am applying the same pressure. Under same pressure conditions, a gas is getting dissolved to the lesser extent, another gas is getting dissolved to the maximum extent, let us consider. So to get maximum value for the maximum extent of gas, KH should be maximum. Similarly, to get lesser value of the dissolved gas quantity, lesser M, KH value should be minimum. So therefore, here the KH value dependency depends on nature of the gas or nature of interactions present between solvent as well as the solute, gas and the solvent.
So therefore here more interactions implies more solubility, more interactions. Stands for what? More solubility. More solubility implies what? Higher will be the KH. Implies KH is more than other. In that way, KH is dependent on the nature of interactions. Suppose if I go for the second case, different temperatures I took. Under different temperatures, what happened to the KH value? Same gas is taken under different temperatures. So therefore, I know solubility is a straight line. Whereas different temperatures I am taking, this is T1 temperature, that is low temperature. This is T2 temperature, relatively some high temperature here I am taking. This is mass of the gas getting dissolved and this is the pressure. Let us see here what's happening here. See, under same pressure conditions at different temperatures, see, at high temperature lower mass is getting dissolved, at low temperature higher mass is getting dissolved. So therefore what happens, with increasing of temperature the amount of mass getting dissolved is small, implies corresponding KH value is also what? Smaller. So therefore with increasing of temperature KH, what will happen to the KH? Decreases. The next case, same gas under different pressure conditions if I take, then what will happen to the KH value? Yes, same gas is there, different pressures. You can consider from the first graph also. Same gas, different pressures. This is pressure 1 condition, this is pressure 2 condition. So therefore here, pressure 1 is here, pressure 2 is here. Higher pressure implies what? Higher will be the KH. Lower pressure implies what? Lower will be the KH. For the same gas, KH value is constant. KH is constant. In that way, KH depends on nature of interactions present between the gas molecule and the solvent molecule, and the temperature conditions that are applied for the solubility. These were the factors, and moreover the units taken for the pressure is also one of the deciding factor. We may express the pressure in terms of atmosphere or in other units like bars or some other derived units. Based on the unit expressed for the pressure, the KH quantity, KH value varies. KH depends on nature of interaction and KH depends on temperature. For the same gas, under different pressure conditions, KH value always remains constant. Thus, how pressure influences the solubility of a gas is given by Henry in the first law, in the form of first law, and it is said to be the Henry's first law, that is mass is proportional to partial pressure of the gas, which can also be given by mass is equal to some constant into partial pressure of the gas. Next, we are going for the discussion of Henry's second law, generally known as Henry's law, which is derived from the first law. What first law says, mass is proportional to pressure. Mass of the gas getting dissolved is proportional to pressure, partial pressure of the gas, and we can write it with a proportionality constant. Mass is equal to some KH into P. If I divide this one by gram molecular weight, this will becomes equal to number of moles of gas is equal to K into K by gram molecular weight of gas into P. Whereas if I once again divide by the number of moles of gas plus total number of moles of solvent, thus it will becomes equal to mole fraction, that is mole fraction of gas will becomes equal to some other new constant. Here I am saying it as KH prime into P. Whereas if I make it as reverse to the other side, so therefore this P will becomes equal to some KH star into partial pressure of the gas. This particular form of law is said to be the Henry's second law. Here what happens is, instead of expressing the mass of the gas, mole fraction of gas is taken as reference. The mole fraction of gas multiple times of some constant will become equal to partial pressure of the gas. So therefore partial pressure will become equal to Henry's constant, new constant, Henry's second constant, KH2, otherwise KH also you can pronounce, into mole fraction of gas is said to be Henry's second law. here you make a difference between Henry's first law constant and second law constant. Here the unit is, mole fraction does not having any kind of units, whereas KH is having units of pressure units. KH units and pressure units are same. Generally we will take it as atmospheres or any other derived units are there. That derived unit is taken. By looking at the units of the Henry's constant, you can make it clear that whether it is Henry's first law or it is of Henry's second law. Then how KH is dependent, then what are the factors affecting over the KH value for different gases, what will happen, and what are the effect of nature of interactions, temperature and pressure over the KH, let us have a discussion. As for Henry's second law graphical version, if you take, yes, this is a liquid, solvent is there, it is a sealed cylinder, it is connected with a cylinder of the gas. Yes, this is gaseous cylinder. Gaseous cylinder is connected with a sealed cylinder of liquid. This gas molecules come over the surface of the liquid and some amount of gas molecules are getting dissolved. Here this particular whole thing is taken as a system, and in that two varieties of substances are there. One is solvent molecules and second one is gaseous molecules, that is nothing but what, solute molecules. I know the weight of solute, I know the gram molecular weight of gas, and here I can calculate the number of moles of the solvent, number of moles of the solute. Thus I can calculate the mole fraction of the solute, yes, and I can calculate the partial pressure offered by the gaseous molecules over its surface. The pressure, this is partial pressure offered by the gaseous molecules over its surface, and here it is having its corresponding vapor pressure and the pressure of the gas. Just I am taking partial pressure of the gas, so therefore partial pressure can be calculatable, mole fraction of the gaseous molecule can be calculatable, and here those who are interrelated by an equality, we are getting a constant, and that constant is known as Henry's constant. Thus partial pressure is equal to mole fraction of gas into Henry's constant, and this is known as Henry's second law. Now we will go for factors affecting on Henry's constant. Factors affecting on Henry's constant. Factors affecting on Henry's constant. Henry's constant. On Henry's constant, which factors generally will influence, and what are its units, and how it is going to be affected by the things present over the homogeneous mixture of gas present inside the liquid. Let us have a discussion. See, some of the gases are getting more soluble, some of the gases are getting less soluble depending on the nature of interactions present between the solvent and the gaseous molecules, temperature as well as the pressure. Now for more soluble gases under given set of conditions, all conditions are same. Here I am applying same temperature, here I am applying same partial pressures, different gases are taken. Some gases are having higher solubility due to its nature, some gases are having lesser solubility. Then lesser solubility gases, Henry's constant versus the lower solubility gases, Henry's constant, what makes the difference, which will be higher, which will be lesser, let us have a discussion. See, some gases, let us see, more soluble gases are there and here less soluble gases are there, case 1. Whereas more soluble gas implies what, its corresponding mole fraction is same. In both the cases pressure is same, this pressure will becomes equal to Henry's constant into mole fraction of gas, and also this pressure is also becomes equal to Henry's constant into mole fraction of the gas. Whereas this pressure and this pressure is same implies what, multiplication product of these two and these two will be equal to one another. But whereas here more soluble implies what, this will be higher quantity. If it is higher quantity, to make it equal, this KH1, this KH of more soluble gas will be less compared to the KH of less soluble gas. This pressure is same implies what? Pressure is equal to more soluble related. Pressure is equal to KH into mole fraction of gas of more soluble, which is equal to KH into mole fraction of gas of less soluble. More soluble implies what? Mole fraction of component is high. Less soluble implies what? Mole fraction of component is less. This is more implies its corresponding KH will be less. This KH of more soluble component will be less compared to the KH of less soluble component. This is case number 1. Now let us go for the second case, that is effect of temperature over the
Henry's constant. Suppose different temperatures if I take, then what will happen to the Henry's constant? And different pressures if I take, then what will happen to the Henry's constant? Next is at different temperatures. Same gas is taken, same solvent is taken. Here I am applying the same partial pressure, but temperature for the solubility condition of the system will be different. Some are at the lower temperature, some are at the higher temperature. Then what will happen to the mole fraction? What will happen to the Henry's constant? Let us have a look. See, here also the same situation it is present. Solvent is present. Solvent is allowed to react with the gas. As a result of this reaction, it is converted as a homogeneous mixture, which is known as what? Solution. And this process is exothermic process. So therefore, in this process, what happens? Some amount of energy will be always getting released. So in this process, energy is releasing implies what? At lower temperature, more amount of gas is getting dissolved. At higher temperature, less amount of gas is getting dissolved. Though I maintain everything is same, partial pressure I am maintaining the same. So partial pressure is maintaining the same, temperature is different. Temperature is different implies what? Quantity of the substance dissolved inside the solvent also varies. At lower temperature, higher amount of quantity will be getting dissolved. At higher temperature, lower amount of quantity is getting dissolved. Let us consider T1 and T2, two temperatures where T1 is lesser than the T2 temperature. Whereas partial pressure will becomes equal to KH into mole fraction of gas. Here also partial pressure will becomes equal to KH into mole fraction of gas. Here, as I said in the beginning, the partial pressure applied is same. Same implies what? This partial pressure is same. Thus, partial pressure is equal to KH into mole fraction of gas under T1 conditions will becomes equal to KH into mole fraction of gas under T2 conditions. As I said, T1 is of which temperature? Lower. If T1 is lower temperature, the quantity of substance that is dissolved under T1 conditions is also less. T1 conditions less implies what? T1 conditions is less. T1 condition is less implies the amount of gas dissolved is more. This mole fraction is more. This is more. Whereas this is relatively less. This is more implies multiplication product of these two things will become equal to one common quantity. Hence implies this KH under T1 condition should be what? Lesser compared to the KH under T2 conditions. If T2 is greater, T2 is higher temperature, that is as temperature increases, then what happens? Mole fraction decreases, quantity of gas that is getting dissolved is decreasing. As a result, its corresponding Henry's constant value is getting increasing. Suppose if I take any gas, in general, if you take any gas under lower temperature conditions to next higher temperature conditions, we observe under high temperature conditions, the Henry constant value will be smaller than the Henry constant of the lower temperature condition. Next one is effect of pressure. For the same gas, if I change the pressure corresponding mole fraction also changes. See, in the same proportion it is going to be changing implies what? This particular pressure will become equal to some constant into, it is proportional to the mole fraction of the gas, which will become equal to Henry's constant into mole fraction of the gas. For the same gas under a broad range of pressure conditions at a constant temperature, under the conditions of which particular conditions? At a constant temperature conditions, this KH value remains constant. If you change the temperature, once again with respect to the temperature increases, KH value increases. Temperature decreases, KH value decreases. But if you maintain same temperature followed by, if you change the pressures, with respect to the change of pressure, the quantity of gas dissolved also varies. The more pressure, more amount of gas is getting dissolved, more will be the mole fraction. So therefore, partial pressure will become equal to constant, Henry's constant into mole fraction of the gas.
in that way it is present, and these are the factors affecting over the solubility of a gas in a solvent to form gas in liquid aqueous solutions, gas in liquid solutions. These are the factors affecting over the solubility, and these are the factors affecting over the Henry's constant. Now we will discuss the validity of Henry's law. When validity of Henry's law is present, under which conditions this Henry's law, that is law 1, mass is proportional to some kh, 1 into partial pressure of the gas, and law 2, partial pressure is equal to, partial pressure is equal to Henry's law constant 2 into mole fraction of the gas. This is Henry's first law and this is Henry's second law. When the validity of Henry's law is present, under which conditions perfectly Henry's law is valid is, yes, there is effect of temperature, there is effect of pressure, there is reactivity related condition, and there is association and the dissociation related condition. Temperature, the required temperature for the validity of Henry's law is low temperature. Under low temperature conditions only Henry's law is valid. If I enhance the temperature a lot, under that condition this Henry's law validity is not having much significance. Hence, to make validity of Henry's law, temperature maintained is of little, low temperature is maintained. Pressure is also low pressure has to be maintained. The more the high pressure that we apply, then what happens is the Henry's law validity becomes very difficult. Low temperature and low pressure conditions are necessary. Third condition is it should not react. Whatever gas we are taking, that gas does not allow to react with the solvent. If it react, then its mass or its mole fraction does not maintain a correlation with respect to the pressure. So therefore reactivity, if it is doing any reactivity with the solvent molecules, then Henry's law is not valid. The solvent molecule and the gaseous molecule should not react with one another. Under that condition only Henry's law is valid. And the last condition is, though it is not reacting, suppose if it is associating, more molecules are combining and converted as single molecule, or if it is dissociating, a single molecule is converted as more than one molecule. Such process is dissociation and the association. If association or dissociation occurs, then calculation of mole fraction becomes very difficult. So therefore under that conditions also this Henry's law is not valid. The perfect validity of Henry's law is having its limitations. It is valid under low pressure, low temperature, non-reacting conditions, in association with. Neither it undergo association nor it undergo dissociation. If these set of conditions are valid, then Henry's law is valid. This is validity and conditions, otherwise limitations of Henry's law. Now let us have a discussion over the applications of Henry's law, where Henry's law is applicable and what are its advanced applications, in which particular part we will take the utility of Henry's law for the beneficiary of the other things. See, Henry's law, that is nothing but what generally Henry's second law is known as Henry's law, that is partial pressure of gas is equal to some constant of Henry, Henry's constant into mole fraction of gas. P is equal to KH into XG, whereas this P is partial pressure of that gas over the liquid. This is not the total pressure, this is the pressure offered by the gas. That is a part and part of total pressure, hence it is said to be what? Partial pressure of what? Partial pressure of gas over the liquid surface, and XG is mole fraction of gas inside the solution, inside the gas present in liquid solution. The mole fraction of the gas is said to be XG. These two are equal to one another by multiplying XG with the some constant, and that constant is said to be Henry's constant. Hence partial pressure is equal to Henry's constant into mole fraction of gas is said to be Henry's law, Henry's constant and Henry's relation. Whereas Henry's law is having lot many applications. See, application number one, suppose soda water is there, we want to prepare more concentrated soda water. That is, carbon dioxide dissolved inside the water is said to be soda water. Carbon dioxide is helpful to remove the excess amount of HCl formed inside the body. So therefore we will often take soda water. So therefore in that soda water generally what happens, carbon dioxide gas is present in the water and that water is said to be what?
Soda water.
In order to increase the concentration of carbon dioxide inside the water, what we have to do? We want to increase the amount of carbon dioxide present in the water, implies what? Mole fraction of gas we want to increase. This mole fraction is increased. What we can increase here? This remains constant. So therefore this is remaining constant, implies what is the variable? Other variable is what?
Pressure.
The pressure offered over the water increases, the pressure of carbon dioxide increases, automatically more amount of carbon dioxide molecules are present over the liquid. The more amount of carbon dioxide is present over the liquid, more amount of carbon dioxide automatically dissolves inside the liquid. So therefore soda water becomes so strong, hence we can say it as strong soda, else it is light soda. Light soda implies what? Quantity of carbon dioxide is less, whereas strong soda stands for what? More concentration of carbon dioxide is present, that is what? More amount of mole fraction is present. More mole fraction implies more amount of carbon dioxide is present, that is soda water. Soda water concentration, strong soda is possible if I apply more amount of carbon dioxide, that is more pressure is applied. And second one is dissolved oxygen. As we know, aquatic life is surviving due to oxygen. That oxygen is present in the water in the dissolved situation is said to be what? Dissolved oxygen. In hot summer, in some areas we will find that aquatic life is getting problem and some fisheries and fishery items are getting death due to insufficient oxygen. Here also you can apply the logic related to the Henry's law to know the situation scientifically. Here under hot temperature conditions, as we said in the beginning, here what happens, generally solvent plus gas, this gas is here oxygen, it is forming solution plus what? Heat. So therefore the dissolution of a gas inside the solvent is an exothermic process. As being it is exothermic process, forward reaction, that is nothing but formation of solution. Formation of solution is nothing but what? Dissolution of gas inside the solvent, and to make a more concentrated homogeneous mixture, that is solution, is possible at low temperature. Whereas as temperature increases, then what happens? Backward reaction favors, solution quantity decreases, implies what? Gas 1 to be free in its gaseous state. Under that condition, mole fraction of gas decreases. Mole fraction of gas decreases under high temperature conditions. Under high temperature condition, mole fraction decreases, implies what happens here? The quantity of dissolved oxygen is less. Quantity of dissolved oxygen is less, implies it is not sufficient for their life process. So therefore most of the aquatic life getting life damaged under very hot conditions. This can be also understood with the help of what? Henry's law. As we said in the last session, that is KH of low temperature and KH of high temperature, we made the discussion. This is T1 and T2. Suppose T2 is higher, at higher temperature what happens? Pressure is same, mole fraction decreases. In order to decrease the value of mole fraction to maintain same pressure, KH should increase. KH should increase implies what? Mole fraction should decrease. Mole fraction decreases implies what? Quantity of oxygen, quantity of dissolved oxygen is less. As the quantity of dissolved oxygen is less, aquatic life is getting damaged. And third condition is divers, scuba divers, whenever they enter inside the deep sea, there is a lot of pressure over the body. Under that pressure condition, the quantity of gas dissolved inside the human body, that is blood, is also more. But when they come out of the bottom of the earth to the surface, then what happens? There is a drastic change in the pressure. When drastic change in pressure occurs, pressure falls. Pressure falls implies what? The quantity of the dissolved oxygen, the quantity of the dissolved gas, mole fraction also decreases. Mathematically, this is a term, mole fraction. But in virginality, what happens? The dissolved gas comes out in the form of virginal gas out. So therefore, within a, suppose a meter, 1 kilometer distance depth of sea level, a diver is there. This diver is coming towards the surface. within some 10 minutes of time. So within that time of 10 minutes, the partial pressure is drastically reduced over him. The mole fraction also drastically reduces. As mole fraction reduces, then what happens? Dissolved gas no way want to be present in its dissolved situation. It will be acquiring its original situation, that as a gas it will come out. When in the veins, that is in the blood vessels, the blood is present, whereas this blood is consisting of dissolved oxygen over here. But when the diver comes to the surface, the dissolved oxygen want to acquiring its gaseous state. So therefore it acquires the corresponding gaseous situation, that implies it forms the bubbles. When bubbles are formed, then bubbles are acting as hurdles for the passage of the blood, and this particular situation is said to be the bends. If this situation is more severe, then person may die. In order to avoid this particular situation, especially for the divers who are going under the deep sea, they used to take a gas mixture of cylinders which is having a combination of, see, helium 32%, nitrogen 56.2%, oxygen is 11.2%. Why this such a combination is required is, see, helium gas is having lesser solubility, nitrogen gas is also having lesser solubility. These gases relatively having lesser solubility implies what? Gases are not present in the dissolved situation. Originally, suppose if I take 100% of oxygen, more amount of gas is present in the dissolved situation. More amount of gas will comes out and appears in the gaseous situation. So therefore, more bends are formed and situation becomes very severe and it is out of our hands. In order to avoid this, the less soluble gases, helium is taken, nitrogen is taken. So therefore, amount of oxygen available which is having relatively high tendency to be present in the dissolved situation is less. Hence, less bend formation is there. So therefore, person may have chance to survive. So this particular combination ratio, percentages of oxygen is little because it is more soluble. Nitrogen 56%, it is also soluble. Helium is taken 32%. To avoid the percentage of, to decrease the percentage of oxygen, a lesser soluble helium gas percentage is provided over there. Thereby, amount of dissolved gas will becomes little under that high pressure conditions, and person is safe not to forming any kind of bends in the blood vessels. And third one is this one, and let us go for the fourth one. Whereas fourth one, here mountains related, mountains at higher altitudes, what happens is the pressure of the gas is little and the pressure of taking process. Whereas mountain taking process is a process in which highest kilometers together mountains are getting taken by the persons. Whereas at higher altitudes, generally the pressure of the gases goes on decreasing. As the overall pressure of the gas is decreasing, let us assume the situation is under a constant temperature conditions. So as the pressure decreases, the partial pressure of the gas also decreases inside the human body. So therefore, the dissolved oxygen condition, dissolved oxygen quantity inside the blood is also little. Then sufficient amount of blood not reaches towards the brain for its proper functionality, and that particular symptoms are said to be anaxia. So anaxia is due to what? Insufficient amount of oxygen. Insufficient amount of oxygen in the blood for the proper functioning of the brain, and that is due to what? Less amount of oxygen. Whereas if they use a cylinders of oxygen where quantity of oxygen is major, so therefore partial pressure is also increased automatically, thereby mole fraction is increased. Sufficient amount of oxygen is available, they will be free from the anaxia. And the next is applications of endosperm. The next condition is, see, hemoglobin present in our body, and hemoglobin takes oxygen from our lungs and it will give to the other parts of the body like cells. This is possible when hemoglobin reaches to our lungs. Then what happens is, there only oxygen is present, oxygen quantity is higher. The pressure of oxygen is higher, so therefore hemoglobin combines with the oxygen and forms oxyhemoglobin, that is mole fraction of the partial pressure of oxygen is more, so therefore amount of oxygen combines with the hemoglobin and it forms oxyhemoglobin. When it reaches to the dispersed parts of the body like cells, bones and other parts of the human system, there oxygen quantity is less.
oxygen quantity is less implies what? Partial pressure of oxygen is less. As a partial pressure of oxygen is less, the amount of dissolved oxygen, the amount of combined oxygen with hemoglobin is also want to maintain less in quantity. To maintain such a less quantity, the hemoglobin and the oxygen combination which is present in the form of oxyhemoglobin want to expel in such a way that it liberates hemoglobin as well as oxygen free. That liberated oxygen is helpful for the life process and the cell's survival of the different parts of the body. Thus, in such a way, with the help of Henry's law, we can explain the life process, that is soda water related process, oxyhemoglobin process, similarly temperature effect, and followed by the Cuva drivers, and followed by the anoxia conditions and the oxyhemoglobin related conditions. These of all are technically related with a scientific way of chemistry known as Henry's law, where Henry's law is partial pressure of gas is proportional to the mole fraction of the dissolved gas in the solution. That is, partial pressure of gas over the liquid will becomes equal to some constant which is known as Henry's constant into mole fraction of gas present in the solution, which is known as Henry's second law, generally known as what? Henry's law. Let us go for a problem on Henry's law, which will covers the whole varieties of problems. Here we are having a problem. See, a 10 liters water containing in a sealed vessel having a total vapor pressure of 0.2 atmospheres and is connected with a cylinder of nitrogen. As a result, the total vapor pressure appears as 0.8 atmospheres. The kH of nitrogen gas at given temperature conditions is 3 into 10 power 2 atmospheres. Then you are asked to calculate the amount of dissolved oxygen in 100 ml of water. See how nice problem is. So this is a vessel. I am giving the graphical presentation of the problem. This is a 10 liter water containing vessel. Vessel capacity is more than 10 liters. In this, total water is 10 liters. And it is a sealed vessel which is connected with a nitrogen cylinder. This is nitrogen cylinder. This is nitrogen cylinder. Before connection of nitrogen cylinder, this particular water is also present in vapor state. As a result, the vapor pressure is found to be 0.2 atmospheres. As being it is sealed vessel, this 0.2 atmospheres is the vapor pressure offered by the water vapor room. Whereas, whenever it is connected to nitrogen cylinder, this is nitrogen cylinder, it is connected to nitrogen cylinder, nitrogen gas molecules also came into this cylinder. As a result, the total pressure appeared as 0.8 atmospheres. 0.8 implies how 0.2 is converted to 0.8 by addition of 0.6 atmospheres. So therefore, this partial pressure offered due to nitrogen is 0.6 atmospheres. Now, the kH value for the nitrogen under given set of temperature conditions is given by 3 into 10 power 2 and that is also present in atmospheres. Atmospheres implies this is Henry's second law. What Henry's law says, partial pressure of gas, that is 0.6 atmospheres, will become equal to kH into mole fraction of gas inside the solution. That is, this gas nitrogen, some portion of this nitrogen gas is getting dissolved inside the solution, whereas its mole fraction into kH will becomes equal to partial pressure. Partial pressure implies the pressure exactly offered by nitrogen. It is not the total pressure, it is not the entire pressure, it is not the entire pressure present over the cylinder. Out of this pressure, a fraction of pressure, a part and part of pressure is offered by our gas. That pressure is this one. This pressure is equal to partial pressure of gas will becomes equal to, otherwise I can write, pressure of gas over the solution will becomes equal to kH into mole fraction of the gas. Here, this partial pressure is 0.6 and this is present in atmospheres. 0.6 atmospheres will becomes equal to
Henry's constant. What is that Henry's constant? 3 × 10^2. This is also present in atmospheres, hence it is very easy. And moreover, mole fraction, that now we have to calculate mole fraction of gas. And here, what is meant by that mole fraction, where it is present? Yes, inside this solution, which is combination of two components. The major component is water, whereas minor component is nitrogen. That nitrogen gas mole fraction is this one. So therefore, 0.6 atmospheres will become equal to 3 × 10^2 mole fraction of gas. Whereas this mole fraction of gas will become equal to 0.6 divided by 3 × 10^2 atmospheres. Atmospheres gets cancelled because mole fraction does not have any kind of units. And this I can write it as 6 × 10^-1 divided by 3 × 10^2. This 1s and this 2s, this will become equal to 2 × 10^-3. This is the mole fraction of the gas. I know this mole fraction of gas implies what? This is mole fraction of nitrogen only. Mole fraction of that gaseous nitrogen will become equal to number of moles of nitrogen divided by number of moles of nitrogen plus number of moles of water. So therefore, this will become equal to number of moles of nitrogen. Mole fraction is very small, 0.002. Hence, on neglecting the corresponding very little quantity of mole fraction, this is what, for what we have to calculate, 100 ml water we have to calculate. 100 ml after eliminating nitrogen, 100 ml is 100 ml, that is 100 grams. So therefore, here number of moles of water will become equal to weight upon gram molecular weight plus very negligible quantity. Here I am not considering this one, I am neglecting. This will become equal to number of moles of nitrogen by, this will become equal to 5.5. So therefore, number of moles of nitrogen will become equal to, what is the mole fraction value? 2 × 10^-3 × 5.55, which will become equal to 11.1 × 10^-3. This is number of moles, whereas here we are asked to calculate the weight of nitrogen present. So therefore, weight of nitrogen will become equal to gram molecular weight 28 × 11.1 × 10^-3, that will approximately 280 plus 28 is 310, approximately 310 × 10^-3 grams, which will become equal to 0.310 grams. Here, what is the amount of nitrogen present within 100 grams of that particular liquid is 0.310 grams of nitrogen is present. In that way, Henry's law can relate partial pressure, Henry's law relates mole fraction, Henry's law relates total quantity, Henry's law relates number of molecules, Henry's law relates number of moles, Henry's law also can be asked to calculate KH of different quantities. Thus, many varieties of things can be interrelated with one formula of the Henry's, known as Henry's law, that is Henry's second law. Partial pressure of gas present over the liquid is equal to mole fraction of that gas in the liquid into constant, Henry's constant, that is P is equal to KH into XG.